Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the RSR Video Email Bag Show. Now here's the man with the fedora, the pinky ring, and the New York thing, your host, Bad Brad Berkwit. Forget about it.
Out of the blue of life, I just picked me a plum. You came along and everything started into hum. Still it's surreal, but bet the best is yet to come.
Hey folks, I love that song, Francis Albert Sinatra. The best is yet to come, forget about it. All right, as I said earlier this week when I shot the last show, that I would be playing Catch Up. See, I said that very slowly, because when I say it quickly, it sounds like catch up. And Deb always says, you doing a show or are you eating some fries and putting some ketchup on them? Forget about it. But hey, nonetheless, I have your great questions. But before we get into those questions, gotta talk a little business. First of all, I want to welcome all of my new subscribers to the RSR Web TV channel. Thank you very much. Second of all, we have not yet hit 850 subscribers, so I must remind you on what you need to do to win this great prize. The Fighting Frenchman, Minnesota's boxing legend, Scott Ledoux. And all you have to do is hit that button in the top right-hand corner and subscribe. Subscribe, subscribe, and subscribe. And you're automatically entered to win that book and many other prizes. I've got a lot of prizes coming up, okay? As we grow in grow in subscribers, we got more and more prizes to give away because I like to take care of my viewers. Now, if you want to be on my next show, very simple, send your questions in to ringsidereport2014@gmail.com. Again, that's ringsidereport2014@gmail.com. Now, if you want to leave a comment, leave them below the video on the Ringside Report Web TV channel. And as I always say, to get respect, you must show respect. And as long as you're respectful to me, I will be more than respectful to you. I never go out of my way to be rude to somebody. But if you take me there, I'll be more than happy to go there with you. I'm not the one for it. I always put that out because you always get a Mama Luke every once in a while, even though if you saw my last show, you heard me say, that I haven't had one in a very long time. But just in case one wants to slip in the door and try me, just in case, all right? Just in case you forgot. Now, without further ado, let's adjust my glasses. Tell you, when you're 22, And as Debbie says, 22, you hit it twice and then some. But you got to adjust your glasses and make sure you have them on, or you're not going to be able to see the questions. Now, without further ado, let's get into your great questions today. First up, I got a little itch here. If I scratch above my eyes, is that money? Or what is that? Is that I'm going to take a shot to the head? I don't know. Forget about it. First up, excuse me, Bad Brad. I have narrowed down my boxing shows to just one. And guess which one that is? Well, I'm hoping this guy says mine, but if he doesn't, that's okay too. Yours, pal. Hey! Thank you very much. How the hell are you not on network TV with your knowledge, calling it like it really is, always and unbiased? The things you said about Deontay Wilder on your last show, even he couldn't dispute if he really wanted to be honest. I wanted to ask you two questions. First, do you really think at this point of his career, even if he got rid of Mark Breland, he could get better? Second, with you being a career military man, who was the best overall fighter to come out of the military first and then turn professional? I can't wait to hear your answers. Everton R. from Salt Lake City, Utah. Wow, Salt Lake City, Utah. That's a new name, folks, and a new place. I don't think I ever had a question from Salt Lake City, Utah. Well, Everton, first of all, thank you very much for the props. I greatly appreciate it. And as far as network TV, I actually was on TV for 12 years. It wasn't my show. I never take credit for things that I didn't do or wasn't involved in, or I shouldn't say if I was involved in it. I never take credit if it wasn't my plat- platform. And even if it is my platform, I still give credit. But for 12 years, 2000 to 2012, I was on a show out of Northern Virginia on News Channel 8, which is the sister station to ABC out there. And it was called Sports Talk with my paisan, Glenn Harris. He was the host. And I was his boxing analyst, as I said, from 2000 to 2012. And I was seen in Virginia, Maryland, D.C., as they call it, the DMV, and West Virginia, of all places. Forget about it. Yeah, I know the old joke. If you're from West Virginia, well, what do they say? They say your family tree has one branch. Well, that's kind of mean, but I hate to say it. There are a few people from West Virginia with a family tree. I'm probably going to alienate some of my viewers, but that's okay. It has one branch. It is what it is. I always call it like I said. So I was on TV for quite a while. But yes, I would love to be on network TV again. Hint, 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 hint. So if you know somebody or somebody's watching this and you'd like to talk to my agent, right now that's me because I got rid of my last one because I did more work than he did. So you could reach out to me. I'd be more than happy to come on your show. Be your guest, come speak to a group of boxing fanatics or wherever. Reach out to me. I'm more than happy to do it. Now, your first question was Deontay Wilder and Mark Breland. As you recall, Everton, on my last show, I'm all about loyalty. But that only goes so far. As what I mean by this, what I mean by what I'm saying there, is this. Mark Breland cannot take Deontay Wilder any further. And actually, I think he's held him back. However, even if Deontay gets rid of Mark right now, okay, and if he does, I hope he gives him a severance letter. I don't know what's going to happen, but he's not going to get that much better. He has almost, what, he's, I think he's 38-0, 37 knockouts, I think is his record. Okay, he's in his 30s. So realistically, what is a new trainer going to do with him? His foundation is in concrete. And if you know boxing, you'll understand what I'm about, this analogy I'm about to give you. You take a fighter that was already great, like a Miguel Cotto, okay, and he goes with Freddie Roach, who was a great trainer, world-class trainer, Boxing Writer Association several times, Trainer of the Year. He's only going to be able to do so much with Miguel Cotto. And when Miguel gets into a tough spot in the ring, he's going to resort back to what he knows, just like Arturo Gatti. Arturo Gatti was a blood and guts warrior. He hit you, you're punch for punch for punch. He bled, he get beat up. So he might come out and box for a few rounds, but the minute he gets cracked or something happens, he's going to resort back to what he knows. And I feel at this point, you can't change much with Deontay Wilder. You could probably make him a little bit better. I'm not unrealistic. Sure, you could maybe fine-tune him a little, but fundamentally, he is what he is, okay? He can't fight. He can't box, okay? He's got mega power, which, as I said on my last show, is always a thing in a fight or in a boxing match and keep you in a fight. But realistically, he has no power, and he hasn't stepped up, with the exception of Bermain Stavine when he won the title. And I don't know about that fight to this day. I'm not saying it was fixed, but if ever a fight looked fixed, that was the fight. How Bermain came in there and basically did nothing is beyond me. I know they said he had this, he had that, but you know, when you have those initials, DK, not for nothing, Don King, you never know what's going to happen. So that's the answer to your first question. No. He can't get better if he left Mark Breland. Realistically, not much better. Maybe a little. So he is what he is. And your next one was, I'm going to say this one. Now, this is during my lifetime. And viewers, if you know somebody from way back in the day, way before I was ever born in 1968, now I'm giving my age away. I just said I was 22. Okay? I just gave it away. All right. Folks. So I was born. We had some technical difficulties. I don't know what the hell happened there. The camera shut off. So hopefully that won't happen again. So let me go on with your questions. Okay, now, Everton, you asked me the second question I was addressing for the camera cut off was, during my lifetime, someone in the military that turned professional, the best fighter during my lifetime, I was in the military and got out to professional. Now, if there was someone back in the day before I was born, as I said before the camera shut off, 68, let me know. But who I'm going to say and who I'm going to pick, I should say, is Ray Mercer. Merciless Ray Mercer was the best. He was in the Army. And he turned pro, I think he turned pro in, I want to say, 88. So I'm going to go with Ray Mercer. All right, Everton, thanks for your great questions, your wonderful compliments. I appreciate you, pal. Send in a question anytime you want. Next up, okay, this is a long one. Bad Brad, I was turned on to your show by a buddy of mine, and I have to quote him because it was hilarious what he said. He said, Joe. If you want truth that is non-bought, funny as shit, and at times never biased, you have to watch this guy called Bad Brad Berkowitz. Okay? He talks more with his hands, which cracks me up because being a New Yorker, we both know how those Italians are. How are those Italians? You want to tell me how those Italians are? How are Italians, pal? You got a problem with Italians? You better talk with my hands. Forget about it. And he goes on to say, that is a direct quote from my oldest friend, Dominic. Well, I watched you and you, SOB. I haven't stopped watching, which includes going back to your very first shows and watching your post-fight wrap-up shows. And dude, your interview show, the Bad Brad Berkowitz show, needs to get optioned for primetime. You care an interview and make your guests feel very comfortable and really open up. I watched one you did with Tommy Morrison's kid, Trey, and I'm telling you, when you asked him to look at the camera and tell the viewers something about his dad that wasn't known but meant something to him, I was in tears. I felt his love for his dad. As a true Blue fan, I truly appreciate your shows, and I'm honored if you take my question for an upcoming RSR video email back show. Being from New York City, I loved Hector Camacho Sr., but felt his antics outside the ring overshadowed his amazing talents in it. What do you think of his career? Joe R. from Bronx, New York. Well, Joe R., and I'm looking closer. Okay, my camera didn't shut off this time. Thank goodness. Hopefully it don't shut off for me again. Well, Joe R. from Bronx, New York, 8 Bison, thank you for the great compliments. And Dominic, that was some pretty funny shit, I gotta admit. That was pretty funny, pal. Okay, when Deb and I are back on the East Coast, we'll be putting a thing out on Facebook. So if you guys are on Facebook, let me know. You come by, you be part of my crew and the party that we're going to have when I go back home. Now, you asked me about Hector Camacho Sr. Well, Hector is one of my favorite fighters of all time. And I couldn't agree with you more, pal. Joe, his antics outside the ring, which I actually personally saw firsthand. I seen him get tooted out of his mind, come to an event in D.C. was great. And then halfway through the night, he was tooted. Nose candy out of his mind, and you know, I do agree that his antics probably outside ring hurt him. However, he recently went into the Hall of Fame, that's the International Boxing Hall of Fame in Canastor, New York, and Hector Camacho in his prime was one of the best boxers I have ever seen. And let's not forget the great trunks and the costumes he wore. He was before Nassim Hamed and all the shtick you see today. He's underrated in some circles, and he gets his just due in others. I think from the hardcore boxing fans, excuse me, he gets his just due. He definitely gets it from me. So he was a great fighter. God rest his soul. Yes, his antics were too much out of the ring. He couldn't behave himself, but then he was known as a bad boy. So hey, God rest his soul. As I said, Hector Camacho Sr., one of the best boxers we ever saw, at least in my lifetime. Okay, in the early to mid 80s, nobody touched Hector. He was the biggest thing in boxing. All right, Joe from the Bronx, New York. That's the answer to your question today. And again, thank you, Dominic, for those wonderful comments. I greatly appreciate those. Now, folks, on that note, we're going to take a short commercial break. Hey, folks, this is Bad Brad Berkowitz, the host of the RSR Video Email Bad Show. Forget about it. And I want to talk to you about an exciting opportunity to advertise or sponsor on my show. If you're interested, send serious business inquiries to Ringside Report 2014@gmail.com. Again, that's ringsidereport 2014@gmail.com. Forget about it.
Excuse me?
What?
Aren't we supposed to be doing a shoot for your book ad?
Yeah, but I'm reading right now. I'm reading an interview in my book with James Quick Tillis. And I tell you what, I didn't realize I did a heck of an interview.
And?
I guess we do need to do this book ad.
Yeah.
Hey, folks, here's the book. Boxing Interviews of a Lifetime by the man with the fedora, the pinky ring, and the New York thing. Me. Forget about it. All right, there it is on the back. Okay, and on the front. Now, how do you order this book? You go to authorhouse.com, and you'll pick it up wholesale. You'll save a few fazools. Forget about it. But if you want to go to Amazon or Barnes & Noble, you can do that too. You're just going to pay retail that way. Now, for all the folks that ask me, yes, I will take this book here if you mail it to me and cover postage and handling to Tulsa and to wherever you live in the world. I will personally autograph your book. Again, Boxing Interviews of a Lifetime by the man with the fedora, the pinky ring, and the New York thing. Forget about it. Bad Bread out. All right, folks, we're now back. And if you are living under a rock and you forgot who the hell I am, I'm the man with the fedora, the pinky ring, and the New York thing. Forget about it. Bad Brad Berkowitz. And this is another RSR video email bag show where I take your questions. I don't cherry pick and I answer them all. Now, don't forget, when we hit 850 subscribers, we're going to randomly pick one subscriber from the United States or around the world. And you're going to win this great book, The Fighting Frenchman, Minnesota's boxing legend, Scott Ledoux. And all you have to do is hit that button in the top right-hand corner and subscribe, subscribe, subscribe. Now, if you want to leave a comment on my show, leave them below. As I always say, show respect, you get respect. Very simple, very simple. All right, remainder of your questions on this show. Next up. Bad Brad, I want to say thank you for inviting me to follow your form. It gave me back the passion of boxing that I once had. I was just recently watching the Super 6 tournament on YouTube, Alan Green versus Glenn Johnson. It seemed to be a close fight until Green took the shot to the back of the head. Do you think it was a cheap shot? If so, do you think that fight would have went different if he didn't get the blow to the back of the head? Signed, Larry Z from Broken Arrow, Oklahoma. Well, Larry Z, welcome back, pal. That's two shows in a row. I'm going to start charging you real estate on my shows. No, you know you can send in a question anytime. First of all, give him a shout out. He's opening up very soon. JR's Guns, which is next to my favorite Italian place here in Tulsa, Uncle Vinny's, which I was actually at last night, at the Three Cheese Manicotti. Shannon and crew, you always do good. Love you guys. Now, also a shout out to Big Larry, who's right next to Uncle Vinny's, and he owns Broken Arrow Gold and Pawn Shop. That's Big Larry, Little Larry's dad. Check my man out. Good guy from the East Coast. The minute you walk in there, he opens up his mouth. You want to give him the business? Tell him you think Sugar Ray Leonard beat Marvin Hagler. Oh, is his blood pressure going to go up and up and up? Okay, I do think that Sugar Ray Leonard beat Marvin Hagler 7-5. I have it on VHS. Every time I scored, I had a 7 Sugar Ray Leonard, 5 for Marvin Hagler. I always said if it would have went 15, because it only went 12, that Hagler was coming on, he would have won the fight. But you want to get Larry Sr.'s blood pressure up, tell him you think Sugar Ray. Tell him you think he won it hands down, and you're going to get him riled up. But again, check him out at Broken Arrow Gold and Pawn Shop in Broken Arrow, Oklahoma. Now, Larry, your question is about Alan Green and Super 6. I saw that fight. I actually saw it live. It wasn't ringside, but I saw it live on TV. Here's the thing with Alan Green, okay? No, I don't think that was a dirty shot. He was stopped. I don't think he would have beat Glenn Johnson, okay? Here's why. Let's be realistic here. Alan Green is a good fighter who has a very solid punch. Absolutely. Can't take those two things away from him. However, he falls in that category, like a lot of fighters do, where he only could hit a certain level. What do I mean by that? Let me break it down for the layman. When he stepped up in competition, he had a good win over Jaden Cornington in 2005. That was a highlight reel where he knocked him out like in seconds. The guy flipped around in ropes. Okay, he beat Carlos De Leon Jr. But they're here. The minute Alan stepped up, his first big fight was against Edison Miranda. In 2007, Alan lost a decision. Then he fought Andre Ward for his title, super middleweight title. He lost, I want to say, 120-108. It was a huge blowout. Then he got totally destroyed by Mikel Kiesler. He got knocked out. And then his last fight in 2013, he lost a decision. I think it was in Australia, don't quote me, but against Blake Caparello. So every time Alan has stepped up to that next level, he has lost. And you have to judge that. I don't care about excuses. All fighters have them. And sometimes there are legit excuses. But every time he stepped up, and I've said the same thing about DC fighters, William Joppy, Sean Bay Mitchell, Keith Holmes, they were world champions. Now, Alan didn't reach that level of becoming a world champion, but he did reach the top contender status to get a title shot. Okay, I don't remember what his ranking was, but he was ranked enough to get a shot against Andre Ward, who was probably pound for pound the best fighter in boxing today. 1A, 1B with Gennady Golovkin. Okay? But Alan couldn't beat those fighters, and neither could Sean Bay Mitchell, William Joppy, or Keith Holmes. Every time they stepped up, they got beat, either decisioned or knocked out. So you have to judge him there. So, like I said again, good fighter, good punch, could not hang with the big boys. It's just what it is. Records speak for themselves. Okay, these are not alternative facts. These are facts. Okay, again, there's your answer, Little Larry. Check them out at JR's Guns, opening up soon. Check out Big Larry, next door to Uncle Vinny's at Broken Arrow, Golden Pawn Shop. I had to look at my note on that one because it's a new one to me. Two great guys, two great businesses, one soon to open. They have my full support. All right, little Larry. Next up is, last question, Bad Brad. I'm a full-blooded Italian and like you, love boxing, Sinatra, and the mafia movie genre and gangsters. Mamma mia! I went to your entertainment site, Newsbreaker, and was in mafia heaven. Between your team of mafia writers from real life to the movies, covering the movies, you got a diehard reader for life. I'm so glad I didn't miss your last show with the commercial about Newsbreaker. I'm looking at my camera. No, it didn't shut up. Okay, so I think the problem was I had too many videos I had to delete. All right, and he goes on to say, I want to stick with all things Italian. Ray Mancini and Vinnie Paz were a little before my time, but I want to get your take on them. And my all-time favorite fighter, the late Arturo Gatti. They are my favorite fighters of all time. Grazie. Vincenzo F. from Tarrytown, New York. Hey, Vincenzo F. from Tarrytown, New York. Forget about it. My old stomping grounds. Used to hang out in Tarrytown all the time. All right. Now, first of all, thank you for the compliments about my team. Yes, we have some great people, and I'm going to say them by name because they are fantastic. You got Roberto Falcone doing the Gangster Chronicles. You got, yeah, real life at one time, Larry Mazza doing the Mazza Report. He was with the Colombo crime family, okay? But he's living the straight and narrow now, and he got a fantastic book out called The Life. I always got to plug my Paisan's book, and anybody that I'm working with on the team, you got something, I'm going to plug it, okay? And it comes with a DVD of the great song, The Life, sung by the amazing Carlos Carr. Now, we also have Joe Little, who's taking a little break. Joe, you better get back, pal. And he covers mafia movies. This young kid, this young cat from England, he knows a ton about mafia movies. Forget about it. And my recent hire, okay? Marla Igar. Oh, I'm sorry, Igar. I said it wrong there. Okay? A sister. Yes, a sister. Who knows? La Cosa Nostra. Okay? All of them are the Mafia crew, Gangsters Incorporated. They write about it. They know it in their head. They put it out in their articles. So, yes, anybody who likes that genre about real-life stories or the movies or stuff associated with Mafia people, check us out at Newsbreaker. That's with a Z, .com. And I can't leave out Jerry Pierce, who covers Sinatra for me, and Christy O'Toole, who covers things that scare the shit out of you, and entertainment. Okay, so I don't want anybody to be left out. Now, your question, okay. Ray Mancini and Vinny Paz, okay? They actually, no shit, are both my paisan. Vinny and I go back a little bit, much longer than Ray and I do. Vinny and I go back 17 years now. Ray and I go back a couple years. Two blood and guts warriors, okay? Vinny with the broken neck, the bleed for this that just came out, his movie. Check it out. I'm sure it's on Blu-ray and probably Netflix and all of those great things. Mancini, take one to land two. Forget about it. Great fighters. Mancini's in the Hall of Fame. Vinny should be in the Hall of Fame too. I don't know what's going on there. But he's in some Hall of Fames, but I'm talking about the International Boxing Hall of Fame. Two great fighters. Vincenzo, can't say enough about him. And two great people. And I'm proud to call him my paisan. And Arturo Gatti. Ah, mamma mia. God rest his soul. Blood and guts war. Do we get any better than Gotti Ward, the trilogy? No, we don't. Gotti, another one. Not a great fighter. But a damn good fighter. Exciting. Gave the fans everything you could ask for in the ring. Okay? And God rest his soul. There's still no closure on what happened to him. He was a great fighter too. Okay? Not a great skilled fighter. Vinny and Ray were more skilled than Arturo. However, Arturo was a exciting, just like they were, in a different way, type of fighter, okay? So all three of them, you can't pick better fighters. I didn't know Arturo personally. I sent a guy one time to cover one of his fights years back when he knocked out Leonard Doreen with a body shot, okay? All right, folks, those are your great questions. Wow, every time you humble me, you really do. You humble the guy with the fedora, the pinky ring, and the New York thing. Forget about it, me. With these great questions, your wonderful compliments, you taking the time to subscribe to my channel, you spreading the word. I see you guys on Facebook. I see everybody supporting me, and I never forget you. And guys that have forums or have stuff going on that give me an accommodation and help me out, when you ask for an accommodation, and if I can make that happen, you know I'm going to rule for you to get it. All right? And on that note, that's another RSR video email bag show in the can. And as Frank Sinatra sang so eloquently so long ago, the best is yet to come. Bad. Brad. Out.